the reasons why I started this channel was to expose people to this little hobby of speaker building that might not have otherwise known about it. Honestly, I don't do this to bring you the latest and most accurate technical information on how to get the best sound from your speakers. I enjoy studying and learning about that stuff, but bringing that to you just isn't what this channel is focused on, despite what people might think it is or want the channel to be. My build videos are meant to inspire. My goal is to catch the eye of someone who might have a parallel interest in electronics or woodworking or just music, and hopefully spark something in them to migrate over to try out this speaker building thing. The problem with that is, unless you're already a woodworker, the tools needed to build the speaker enclosure can be a real barrier for most people. So I'm always looking for ways to bypass that barrier, and I've done that in the past using mason jars and ceramic coffee and tea jars. But this time I'm trying something a little different, and I think it's gonna make the build process a little easier and faster for most people. Hey everyone, I'm Kirby, this is Kirby Meets Audio, and today we're gonna build one of my first speaker designs, the Fawn Speaker. But before we get into it, I want to tell you about this video sponsor, Wix. Wix is a free platform that allows you to build professional and robust websites. You can use simple drag and drop tools to create a website for whatever you're doing online. There's tools for video, photo galleries, bookings, e-commerce, music, events, restaurants, whatever you're doing. They got you covered. Wix offers hundreds of awesome templates, unlimited pages, and top-grade hosting for free. Upgrade to one of their premium plans for as little as $5 a month for even more. I recently used Wix to build a new website for you guys over at kmaspeakerdesigns.com. This site is going to be the new home for all the speaker design content I put out. So right now you can head over there and download the free PDF worksheets for the How to Design a Speaker in 6 Steps series. There's also some of my more informative videos on my enclosure process and crossover designs, so go check that out. There's a link down in the description. So I've been using Wix to build and host this new site, and so far it's been great. The tools they offer allow me to do everything I need to set up the site the way I want it. And I'm really excited for you guys to check it out. If you're looking to build a new website, maybe you want to start selling those speakers you've been making or thinking about making, you should get on that by the way, and you want to help out this channel, check out Wix by clicking the link down in the description. All right, let's start this build. Thank you. Offering this speaker design in a wood kit to go with the Fawn speaker component kits. If you get the kit, you don't need any fancy tools to make these speakers, just something heavy for the glue up, a screwdriver, some sandpaper, and finish. And you can find all these at kmakits.com. I first used this lag bolt idea to secure the front baffle on the Moro speakers that I put together in the last build video, and I'm really happy with how it's working out so far. With gasket tape, it makes a really nice seal around the joint, and it seems to be secure enough, at least for these smaller speakers. It would be interesting to stretch this idea out a bit and try it out on some bigger speakers to see if or when it starts to fail, but that might be a future video. Who knows? We'll see. I did run into a few problems with this build. The adhesive on the vinyl I picked out to cover the enclosure didn't stick to the corners as well as I'd hoped. Although later on, I did go back and use a little heat from a heat gun to help stretch the vinyl around the corners, and that helped out a little bit. But I think next time or in the future, I'll try to seal the MDF before applying the vinyl to give it more surface for it to stick to. I think that might help out. So I know vinyl isn't the most popular finishing solution, but I do think that it has the potential to be a great solution for people who might not be confident with a paint finish. But what do you guys think? Do you have suggestions for making the application of the vinyl a little bit better, making it stick better? Or do you have an idea for, you know, a different easy finishing solution? I don't know. Let me know down in the comments. All right. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you guys have a great holiday. I probably won't see you till after the holidays. But yeah, thanks for hanging out. See you guys. Bye.